One of the things I learned early on in real estate investing, or maybe not early on enough, or maybe not soon enough, is figuring out what you're not good at and what you want to outsource or what you want to get other people to do. I know when I first started out in real estate investing, I tried to do everything myself, literally everything. I would write my own offers. I went to a website. I found the agreement of purchase and sales for that area. I downloaded it. I remembered spending hours trying to transform that that PDF, because it usually comes in a PDF that's not fillable. I mean, this was years ago, right? This 20 some years ago. And then what I did is I converted it to a Word document. I spent all the time formatting it. And then I would go through and I'd type up all the information on the offer. I'd put in all the name of the person, the address, the price, the closing, the terms. And at that point, I really didn't know any of the legal sides of a real estate transaction. I remember putting in all the clauses, because I had taken all these courses, right? And I knew the types of clauses that you should be putting in there. And then I would take and I'd submit that offer to an owner. And I was doing this all by myself. And sometimes I would do it to an agent that was listing the property, or I'd find these people listing these properties on for sale by owner sites. So again, I was doing all the offers myself. I would go out, so I had the marketing, I had the offers, and then I would go out and I'd negotiate the close, right? Instead of getting a realtor involved, I'd submit the offer, and then I'd talk to the owner and I'd negotiate the close. And I did that in a few instances where it made sense. And in the long run, I learned a lot from doing that. But I should have engaged a realtor a lot early on in the process, because those are the experts. They can actually, a good realtor will actually save you money. And then when it came down to closing the deal or closing the offer, I did have to get a lawyer involved. In my community, we need a lawyer. Some places they use different types of legal transactions where you may not require a lawyer, but it's another type of legal person to close the transaction. And when I remember the first time I did it and I got my lawyer involved, he looked at the offer. He said, like, you know, he poked a whole bunch of holes in it. So, you know, you got to be careful when you're doing things yourself. The other thing I did is I set up all my own financials. I did all my own bookkeeping. I did all my own accounting. So what was happening by doing all these, what I would call $25, $50 an hour type jobs, is I'm taking away time where I should be spending more time finding deals, negotiating deals. And then once I did that, once I decided that I couldn't do everything myself and I started hiring the professionals to do that, that's when I really scaled my growth, or that's when I really started to build my portfolio. And that's where I went from, I think at one point I had 5 properties, and within a 3-year period, I had grown to over 100 properties. And at that point I had everything. I had salespeople, I had bookkeepers, I had lawyers, I had accountants. I had really built up my team that allowed me to scale. So make sure that you don't try to do everything yourself and that you get the professionals to do the jobs that makes the most sense.